ask of you one thing that we desire, that as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise, King of Kings, Holy God, as we sing.
Official, we are in the land of the living. Yes, we are here. We are alive. We are alive. Yes, as we arise in the morning to give him praise and give him thanks, give him glory, give him honor, because he has done it again. Another time in the land of the living. Father God, we thank you in the name of Jesus. This day was never promised, but of God, you have granted it. And Father God, we receive it gladly this morning, Lord Jesus. We don't say thank you enough, Father, but God, we mean well on the inside. We thank you, Jesus. We say thank you, Lord. We thank you for another day. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you. Everything is working. We can see, we can hear, we can walk. Food in the refrigerator, Almighty God. Father, we thank you. Bills are paid, Almighty God. Father, and most of all, we thank you for life. We thank you for your son, Jesus, who came to give us a chance, Lord, that we can get back into the Garden of Eden. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that your will be done in this segment. Have your will, have your way. Have your perfect will, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. It's a rise in the morning. Yes, indeed. As we greet you mightily, shake yourself off.
Praises of your people.
Come on, shake off whatever it is.
How about there tonight?
We're going to get out there today and make a difference.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises.
Come on.
We lift you up. Up. We lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises.
We lift.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises. Arise, make
your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise,
arise,
King of kings,
mighty people,
holy God.
All those on the phone lines, good morning to you. 213-493-0146. All those on the tune in, good morning. All those on the website, www.choicegospelnetwork.com. Hey, all the drivers on the street, morning to you. We greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, Gene. Morning to you, man. Cipriani. Wow. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. We made it. We made it. Woo. Another day in the land of the living. Yes. We did it again. Woo! Glory to the name of Jesus. One more day in the land of the living. Give yourself a round of applause. You made it. Mommy wants to say, wake up. Wake up, girl. Woo! Man, just getting up, doing their preparation, whatever is going to go on today. Definitely indeed, man. They say the early bird catches the worm. Nice to wake up in the morning. Not easy sometimes to get up out of a beautiful sleep, but once you arise, man, everything ahead of you is just nice, beautiful to feel the nice breeze in the morning time. Nice fresh air on your face. So we give thanks. We are thankful for life this morning. It's called Arise in the morning. As we lift you up with a positive posture. If it's not positive, we try to make it positive. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Keep an open mind as you listen to this segment. As we come here in the name of the Lord Jesus. All right, guys. So be blessed as we continue this segment right about now. Call a friend, tell them to tune in. Catch it live. Encourage yourself this morning. Morning to my beautiful wife.
And how can I give praise?
How can I?
Lord, you've given me so much. You gave it all. You paid the price. Now I want to give you my life as a sacrifice of praise. Oh, I lift it up to you. Lord, I give my heart away. Give it all to you. Lord, make my life an offering. Let me worship you in everything I do. Sacrifice of praise I give.
sacrifice of praise.
Sacrifice of praise.
Oh, I lift it up to you.
Going out a little extra.
And Lord, I give my heart away.
Making an extra effort.
Oh, I give it all to you.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Lord, make my life an offering. Let me worship you in everything I do. A sacrifice of praise.
Good morning, Pastor Green.
I give
Edwin
to you. Sacrifice of praise.
Pastor St. Louis, morning to you.
To you.
Morning, Deacon Charles.
Lord, I give my heart away. Oh, I give it all to you.
Hey, Pastor Foster, morning.
Lord, make my life an offering. Let me worship you.
Mullins.
Everything I do.
Lift him up this morning. Don't care what you feel like. Lift him up. Yes. Hey. It's a rise in the morning indeed. We're taking a reading right here from the book of Ecclesiastic. Very, very interesting book. And indeed, man, you know, God is just awesome. Everything is here for us if we are willing to humble ourselves before the mighty hand of God and allow him to shape us in his image and likeness. In every aspect of our life, glory to the name of Jesus. Ecclesiastes 7, we're going to start right from 1. It says, a good name is better than precious ointment, and the day of death than the day of one's birth. It is better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting. For that is the end of all men, and the living will lay it to his heart. Sorrow is better than laughter, for by sadness of the countenance, the heart is made better. The heart of the wise is in the house of the mourning, but the heart of fools is in the house of mirth. It is better to hear the rebuke of the wise than for a man to hear the song of fools. For as the crackling of horns under a pot, so is the laughter of the fool. This also is vanity. Surely, oppression maketh a wise man mad, and a gift destroyeth the heart. Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. And the patience in spirit is better than the proud in spirit. Be not hasty in thy spirit to be angry, for angry resteth in the bosoms of fools. Glory to the name of Jesus. We thank him. New day in the land of the living. 14 minutes after the 7 o'clock. If you get in there for age, you got to be moving. Come on, wake up with a positive mind, positive attitude. You're right here in the land of the living. Miss S, good morning. How are you doing?
Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day. When Jesus was. Oh, when he was. Happy day. Oh, happy day. was my sin joy.
Indeed, it's the easy day inside of the fourth month. And many people listen to hear me talk about Good Friday. Well, you're waiting to hear that, right? Yeah, you're not gonna hear that. It's a day of commemoration. We'd rather say it's a commemoration. We're in solidarity. We're not celebrating nothing. We celebrate when He has risen. Fulfill divine justice. That's when we celebrate after He has risen. Right now we stand at attention. We stand at ease in solidarity. Glory to the name of Jesus. We celebrate the completion. The power to rise. That is what every Christian should celebrate. You can't be double-minded, celebrating on both sides. I'm celebrating you dying, celebrating you rising. Am I confused or what? Which celebration is bigger? Do I celebrate a little while you die and celebrate more when you arise? Which one is it? Choose one. We thank God for His saving power. Thank Him for salvation. Glory to the name of Jesus. So based on what history does, we're in solidarity. We're in solidarity. If that's the mood of it, we are in solidarity. We salute. We're not joyful. Glory. It's hard to get away from things you have been indoctrinated with for years. Engrave a place in your heart, in your mind, in your soul, in your spirit. Make an engraving. Left a tattoo. Since you was a child, you've been doing it. I understand. That's what we are faced with, my brethren. This life is real. Life is real. Let's be realistic. Wake up and get real. Yes, we got power. Our words are power. So we commemorate. We stand in solidarity. 22 minutes past the 2 o'clock, getting there for 8 o'clock. You gotta keep it moving. Who's already on the job? Good morning to you. Hey, Shamin. What's up? Hey, Sister Gloria.
Saved me. I'm no longer the same. Since the day you found me and made my life brand new. Oh, I can't stop shouting and I can't stop praising. No, I can't stop dancing. Oh, can't stop singing. I can't stop raging. I can't stop dancing.
Happy that we are alive. Yes, indeed. Arise in the morning. Brother Earl and your wife, good morning. All those on the front line for Jesus. Yeah, man. Good morning to you. Voice of Miss Ocean Pierce. Yeah. Lewin.
Every chain. There is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power
in the name of Jesus.
There is power
in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Break every chain.
Yeah.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Brother Derek, morning to you. Hey, morning, Jennifer. Just the Lamont morning. All the families there. It's the Paula morning.
Break it up.
Oakley.
Break it up, break it up.
It's Gabriel morning.
Break it up, break it up.
It's the Lorna morning.
Yeah.
Gunpot morning. Chanty.
Hey.
We know what his name did for us, man. That's why we are so jovial. Power in the name of Jesus. Transformation. Do you want a new life? It's right here in Jesus. Yes. Let him break every chain in your life. Morning, Malik.
There is power.
All those newly baptized, good morning.
Oh, 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 oh. Those chains of addiction, bring it up.
Yes.
Bring it up.
Oh, oh, oh.
Those chains of drugs, bring it up. Bring it up.
Oh, oh, oh.
Morning, Brother Pat. Dr. Paul, morning to you. Do you know that?
Name.
Oh, it's 31 minutes past 7 o'clock. Get in there for 8 o'clock, you gotta keep moving it. Indeed, it's a beautiful morning in the city. As we give him praise, we give him thanks, amen. Hey guys, don't care what it is, man. We have life, we got hope, amen. I know you hear it all the time. Gotta appreciate it, amen. Pastor Lillian, morning.
There is power.
Brother Cardo, morning to you, man. All those catching the segment in the morning time, we thank you. Thank you for your time. Thank you for tuning in. As we lift up the name of Jesus, the name that has saved us, amen.
This
black man, morning to you.
In the name of Jesus.
And all the family, man, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Who understand this life.
Name of Jesus.
And who is willing to grow in this life.
In the name.
Rachel, good morning to you.
Well, in the name of Jesus.
Bring Brother Kern, morning to you, sir.
Bring every chain.
Brother Calvin.
Bread of life sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king. A carpenter, but you are the living word. Say it now. Come on.
Sent down from glory.
Many things you were on earth. A holy king, a carpenter. Come on, Houston, you can say it one time with us.
Bread.
Sent down from glory. Many things. Come on, somebody say it.
Many things you were on earth.
Brother Philip Morning and your wife, family.
You are an awesome ruler. This is what we like to call you, Jesus, Jesus. That's what we call you, yeah. You were born in a manger, but on a tree
you died to save man.
The Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus.
That's what we call you.
This is Mario Monroe Morning. This Bowers. This Morrison. All those on the front line. Linda Morning.
I wonder, can I get the saints all over the world to say, oh, no matter where you find yourself, say it.
Daphne Morning. Sister Pamela Morning to you. Sister Samuel.
Can you say it one more time?
Dolly and Fabi Morning.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, say it. Lift your voice and say it. Now let's call it one more time and say, Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus,
that's what we call you, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus.
Oh man, I gotta take this one all the way from the tip top, indeed.
Bread of life.
Bread of life.
Sent down.
Hope you're in a good frame of mind this morning, amen.
Many things you were on earth.
Thank you, Jesus. Humble us this morning, Father. Humble us this morning. Humble us this morning.
Bread.
To acknowledge that only you are the great I am. Amen.
Sent down.
Humble us inside out. Yes, Lord Jesus.
Many things you were on earth. A holy king, a carpenter. But you are the living word. Come on.
Sent down from glory.
Many things you were on earth. A holy king, a carpenter.
Come on, Houston, you can say it one time with us.
Bread.
Hey, my friend from Haiti, morning to you and your wife and the kids. Just forgot the name.
Come on, somebody say it.
Yeah, we appreciate you guys, man. Everybody.
Awesome ruler,
awesome ruler.
Brooks, morning to you.
God with us,
God with us. The living truth, and what a friend we have in you.
Can tell redeemer, God with us, yeah.
together, this is what we'd like to call you, Jesus, Jesus. That's what we call you, yeah.
Hallelujah. Died to save humanity.
You
need to pray to be more humble. As human beings, I'm telling you, man. Able to devour self as much as we can as we walk this walk. Yes.
That's what we call you.
Humble ourselves in the equation as we acknowledge how vulnerable we are as human beings here today, gone tomorrow. Why do we boast of ourselves and our existence? Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Arise in the morning. Wake up. It's early in the morning. Brother Stephen.
Somebody, when I can't say nothing else.
What's going on, Ozzy?
Oh, 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 oh. I wonder, can I get the saints all over the world to say, find yourself there.
Miss Maureen. As we reflect on him, him who gave his life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. It's a rise in the morning on the Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. You give it praise. Put a smile on your face. Come on. Get in that bag. In the land of the living, what you want? Come on. There for 8 o'clock, you gotta move it. This is a Nichols morning. Wake up with power this morning. In the name of Jesus. Arise, mighty people.
I will speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough. Speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough. For you are the great and mighty King. You rule in every nation. Oh Christ, the only God. You are worthy. speaks of your glory and the earth of your beauty. Your love is new every morning, and your faithfulness is never shown. For you are the great and mighty God, so greatly to be praised. Your beautiful constellation, you are the joy of the whole world. For you are the great and mighty God, so greatly to be praised. Your beautiful constellation.
Man, it's something else in the morning time. Giving praise. Bow before him. Knowing where he took you from. Bow before him. Humble yourself this morning. Bow before him.
Jesus, my Lord.
Hallelujah.
My Lord. You are the joy of the whole world.
And in John 19, then Pilate therefore took Jesus and scourged him. And the soldiers planted a crown of thorns and put it on his head. And they put on him a purple robe and said, Hail, King of the Jews. And they smote him with their hands. Pilate therefore went forth again and said unto them, Behold, I bring him forth to you, that ye may know that I find no fault in him.
You are the joy of the whole world.
Then came Jesus forth, wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. And Pilate said unto them, Behold the man.
You are the joy of the whole world.
When the chief priests therefore and the officers saw him, they cried out, saying, Crucify him! Crucify him! Pilate said unto them, Take ye him and crucify him, for I find no fault in him.
You are the joy of the whole world.
Ten more minutes to the top of the hour. The danger of indoctrination. Wake up, mighty people. Do you have a receptive heart that can be renewed and be transformed? That's what he asks us to do. Be transformed by the renewing of our mind. How can we celebrate that? Can a mother celebrate the dying of her son? Can you celebrate the dying of your child? Can you celebrate it actually? Without knowing the future? Can you really do that? 9 more minutes to the top of the hour. Stand in solidarity.
Jesus, I will speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough. I will speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough. I say every space of your glory and the earth of your beauty. Your love is new every morning and your faithfulness is ever shown. For you are the great and mighty God, so great that to be praised. Your beautiful voice in the you are the joy of the whole world. For you are the great and mighty God, so great. Your beautiful voice in a way, so
Hallelujah, Jesus.
You are the joy.
Let's give him praise.
You are the greatest.
As we continue in the book of John 19 and 17, it reads,
praise.
And he bearing his cross went forth into a place called
you are the, joy of
the place of his skull,
you are the greatest.
Which is called in Hebrew Golgotha,
so
where they crucified him and two others with him on either side, one and Jesus in the midst. And Pilate wrote a title and put it on the cross, and the writing was Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews. This title then read many of the Jews. For the place where Jesus was crucified was nigh to the city, and it was written in Hebrew and Greek and Latin. Then said the chief priests of the Jews to Pilate, write not King of the Jews, but that he said, I am King of the Jews. Pilate answered, what I have written, I have written. Then the soldiers, when they have crucified Jesus, took his garments and made four parts, to every soldier a part, and also his coat. Now the coat was without seam, woven from the top throughout. They said therefore among themselves, let us not rend it, but cast lots for it, whose it shall be, that the scripture might be fulfilled, which saith, they parted my raiment among themselves, and for my vesture they did cast lots. These things therefore the soldiers did. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus his mother and his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by, whom he loved, he saith unto his mother, woman, behold thy son. Then saith him to the disciples, behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her into his own home. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, saith, I thirst. Now there was set a vessel full of vinegar.
You are the great and mighty God.
He filled the sponge with vinegar and put it upon hyssop and put it in his mouth.
You are the great.
When Jesus therefore has received the vinegar, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost.
You are the great and mighty God. So grand that you be praised. Beautiful voice in a whisper. You are the joy of the whole world.
You are the great and mighty God. So grand that you be praised. Beautiful voice in a whisper.
You are the joy of the
whole world. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Oh man, the time has just gone.
Jesus, my Lord.
Wow.
Jesus, my Lord.
You are the joy of the whole world.
Jesus, my Lord.
You are the joy of the whole world.
Jesus, my... I'm going to play it one more time. One more time. One more time, Sister Charmaine. And all the family on the outside in the radio land, good morning. It's called Arise in the Morning when we lift you up with Jesus on your mind and the big sacrifice he had made to redeem us, indeed. For those who really receive that gift and understand the power of it. Salvation. I'm telling you, man, what a vibration in the studio. Good morning to you if you're driving. Be cautious on the road. Hope you enjoy the segments. Yes, indeed. Yeah, the power of information, the power of education. Power of indoctrination. Yeah, man. Many things we grow up with as children. And we grow into big men and women. And don't care how much we see or hear the truth, we are not willing to break away from it. Because all information is so engraved into our system. This Friday morning, we just keep the phone open. If there is something on your mind. If you have a testimony this morning that you want to share with us, feel free to do so. A very tense conversation yesterday, talking about the difference of being a Christian and relating to the world and parties and carnivals and stuff like that. And I know many times, you know, people hear this kind of conversation, they take it really serious and they take it on the defensive. Instead of taking it in a positive posture, looking at the positive of it. As our people perish for lack of knowledge and information, that we must continue to be renewed in our mind. As Christians, if you're a Christian, you're a child of God, we must be receptive to things that can help us develop and be stronger as a Christian in our walk. Amen. We cannot limit ourselves. Because remember, the devil continually tried to pull you back in a state of nothingness. So he's constantly trying to make you identify with the world, although you're claiming to be born new. So we must be vigilant as Christians out there, amen. I know sometimes when the truth comes at you, it hits you really hard. You know what I mean? And that's life, you know what I mean? When the truth comes, it's gonna hit you, you know what I mean? But we must be mature. We must be willing to grow into the truth and cast it down for what it is as we move into light. That should be the attitude of any human being.
Jesus,
an open mind, positive posture to move forward in life. Amen.
When
we talk about definitely the power of indoctrination, how devastating it is. You know, that's why every man has to work out their own salvation. It doesn't make a difference what your parents tell you or what your grandmother taught you or whatever it is. God has given you a brain and he's given you the time. He has, through his grace and mercy, he has kept you that you are going to know the truth, that you could search it out and find out what it is. Amen. So we all in life must be receptive to change. We must be receptive to new information. We must be receptive to new information. Regardless to what it is, we check it out and see if it's what it is. Amen. So it's good that we you know, sometimes we raise certain conversation. That's what it's supposed to be. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. So like I said, this morning the phone is open, and then, you know, if something is on your mind, and you know, normally they celebrate Good Friday. That's what they celebrate, right? Well, like I said, to me personally, I don't know how any man or any woman can celebrate the death of their child. That's just me talking, just, you know, I don't know how we could celebrate it. You see, now you could say we celebrate it because of what it does, but you don't know the future. So how would you celebrate what you don't know? If your son die, your child die, whatever, how do you celebrate that? I don't understand it. Regardless to what's going to be the outcome of it, how do you celebrate that day? You know what I mean? How do you celebrate somebody dying? You know what I mean? That's what you know? So that's the element of the conversation. And you see, we have to understand that the enemy is continually looking for ways to trap the children of God, because, you know, what we say in our mouth have a lot of power. So you saying you're celebrating the death of someone and saying you're celebrating when they rise, it's contradiction. It's like, you know, you double-minded. Which one are you going to celebrate? Are you going to celebrate the death or the resurrection? Which one are you going to celebrate? I mean, you know, just let's be, you know, which way it is, you know. You lost a piece of jewelry and you were sad, and now you got it back. And now you rejoice, my goodness, I got it back. So it cannot be the same emotion for the same thing, you know what I mean? So definitely indeed. And it's dangerous when indoctrination is such a dangerous trend. And that's why I say to everybody, I don't care what religion you were raised in, I don't care what your parents taught you, what you saw them doing when you're growing up, this is your life, and you need to find out what really is about this thing. Where do I go from here? What happens next? You need to validate everything that you have come into as a young man or a young woman growing up. Once you got life, it's your duty. It's your duty to find out if what you believed in all along is what it is. Is there all to the story, or is there more information that I need to find out? God has given us the willpower through his grace. And we always talk about the grace of God. That's what the grace of God is. If God feels you have to move you from one country to the next, that you will hear certain vital information, that's the God we're talking about. That's who he is. Because he knew if you stayed certain places, there is certain things would have never happened in your life. And that is how we should validate the grace and mercy of the Almighty God. We give him praise this morning. He's worthy of it.
Let us make a joyful noise and to the Lord.
So if you get in there for 9 o'clock, keep it moving.
Blessed assurance.
The phone number here, 347-663-8638.
Jesus is mine.
If you have a testimony,
oh, what a,
feel free to share it. Our God is awesome, always working.
Of glory divine.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Year of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit,
Jesus. Wash.
As we go to the first call on the line. Caller, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great, my sister. How are you?
I am doing wonderful.
Hallelujah.
I must say I'm enjoying your radio station this morning. And I'm actually calling to find out the name of the song that you kept playing over and over before this one.
Oh, it's called Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Yes, Mighty God from Joe Praise. The name of the person is Joe Praise. P-R-A-Z. P-R-A-Z-E. Praise, Joe Praise.
Okay.
All right.
Wonderful. Anything? That song is so beautiful.
Amen. It is beautiful, right?
It is. The great and mighty God.
He is the great I am, my sister.
He's a wonderful Savior.
Hallelujah.
There's simply so much about him that is so awesome and beautiful. He is indeed the great and mighty God.
I'm going to play it one more time.
I pray that you will continue to do the good work of the Lord God Almighty, and that God will continue to bless you bountifully.
In Jesus' name, I receive it, my sister. One more time for you, Joe.
Have
Praise.
Have a wonderful day.
You too, darling. All right.
Thank you.
One more time. He is the great I am. And those of us who really receive Christ Jesus. That's why I say there is so much more to Jesus. And if we lay down our life and lay down ourselves to really receive him, man, tell you the truth, man, there's no way you could just be dry like a Christian. No way. Mm-mm. Not after receiving Jesus. You could never be the same. And you should never be the same. Joe Praise, the name. I think he's out of Soweto.
Show for your beauty. If I dance, it would be enough. And if I shout, it would be enough. I will speak of your glory. I will show for your beauty. If I dance, it would be enough. And if I shout, it would be enough. For you are the great and mighty King.
Back to the phone caller. Good morning.
Praise the Lord, Minister Stryker. How are you?
I'm doing great, my sister, in the land of the living. How are you doing?
I am well, thank God. I was sick for the past 2 days. I was knocked out sleeping yesterday with while your program was on. That's how tired, sick I was. But I thank God I'm in the land of the living. He gave me strength this morning. I'm getting better and not worse. So I want to praise his name this morning and give him thanks.
All right, you know,
thank you, Jesus.
You are well and you are not sick, amen.
Amen. I'm well and not sick.
Yes, you give him praise, you give him glory. What
in
are you
Jesus
thankful for this
name.
Morning? Life in Jesus, right?
In Jesus, amen.
Amen, my sister. Be blessed.
Thank you. You
thank
too.
You.
Be
all
blessed.
Right, yes, man. 347-663-8638. If you have a testimony this morning of the goodness of the Almighty God, don't be shy, don't be intimidated.
Beauty. If I dance, it should be enough. And if I shout, it should be.
worship.
I see every space of your glory and the earth of your beauty. Your love is new every morning, and your faithfulness is never show. For you are the great and mighty God, so greatly to be praised. Your beautiful voice in worship. You are the joy of the whole world. For you are the great and mighty God, so greatly to be praised. Your beautiful voice in worship.
Give him praise this morning. Thank him for your salvation. 347-6638-638. It's a rise in the morning. If you have something you want to share with us, feel free to share with us. Beautiful in all situations. Makes you are able to rise out of yourself. Many times our self make us transgress against God because of our pride. We don't want to kill self at all. Sometimes when the truth comes to us, we don't want to receive it as if we are bigger than the truth. But the truth is the truth. Let the truth set you free. Danger of indoctrination. And all of you growing up, I mean, you know, as children, you know, you learn so much things back in the islands, you know, so much things as a child, and you grow into so many things that you really thought that the way it was, and you come to realize, man, that's not the way it is. But you know, God wants us to be strong children of His who hear His voice and is willing to make a move in His direction. Amen. So that's something that important that we have to pay attention to. God wants every man to come into the wisdom and the truth of Him. Hallelujah. Not of man. Not what nobody tell you. Not what your grandmother used to do or your grandfather or your father. They all could be wrong. Yeah, hallelujah. We, each and every one of us, we are individuals. Hallelujah. As much as we respect our parents and we acknowledge them, what they have done, whatever. At the end of the day, you're going to be on your own. And we all need to walk out our salvation. Hallelujah. And sometimes we get so defensive, even defending our religion and our denomination. That has nothing to do with the truth. You know what I mean? We just defend people all the time and, you know, we defend our country. What? Your country going to be there. You're going to die and your country going to be there just the same way. Many have gone before your country. Your country continue to exist. Your country don't care if you're dead or you're living, you know. We mourn for 2 days and after that, so you're gone, so what? But we have to know that our life is important, that we defend our eternal reward. We must defend that. So that's important for us to come to a place of maturity as human beings, that we are able to be mature based on how Christ asks us to be transformed by the renewing of our mind. Amen. Many times we argue and we carry on a lot, and what we arguing about? Our denomination or our religion, what they believe. Well, what the Bible say? What Jesus believe? Who was Jesus? What he came for? Who did he die for? Did he start a religion? What was the name of it? You know, we must come to those fundamental places in life. That's what God wants. God is looking for people who can think individually as we relate to Him and who He is and was and is to come. We must Look at life in that perspective, or else we all are going to perish, just like our foreparents, if we don't come to a new alignment and know that this thing is about us. We have a future to defend. We have an eternal life to defend. So we must come to a place where we are willing to accept reality for reality, accept truth for truth. That is what life is all about. That is what life is all about. I remember speaking to a young man and he was telling me, show me hell in the Bible. I said, man, this guy is going on. There is no hell in the Bible. I'm just saying, this guy, I mean, the guy was so hot about this thing. He was hot about it. He was going on about this thing. He was hot about it. So, you know what I'm saying? The power of indoctrination, it's very serious. You know what I mean? It's serious. And I'm talking about the Good Friday that people say, wait, what is good about it? What is good is the resurrection. What is good is the result of it. What we get from it, that's what's good of it. And I'm comfortable in myself talking about it because that's really what it is. So it's nothing wrong with commemorating. We all should be in solidarity. You know what I mean? We stand in solidarity as our Lord and Savior goes to be crucified. We stand there. We're not laughing with them. We're not celebrating with them. No. They're killing him. Yes, it's going to be for our benefit after when we find out the plan of salvation. But while he's being crucified, we're not celebrating that. We are stone-faced. We are serious. They are killing him. But when he has risen, now we are celebrating. I'm comfortable with that picture. I'm comfortable with that persona. I think that's what it is. We all stand in solidarity. His mother was crying. All the disciples was, that's what it was. So if we are of that same family, we have to take that same kind of attitude towards it. Hallelujah. So how could it be a good day? Good for who? You don't know the future. It's good for God. God the Father, he know the beginning to the end. So it's good for him. He know his plan. The devil don't know his plan. Nobody knows. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So he know the beginning. He know the beginning to the end. So he's good for him. But it's not good for you. What make it good for you? What's make it good for us? It's not good. We commemorate that time. Then we celebrate the jubilation. We celebrate when he have arisen. We celebrate that time. We don't celebrate when he's going to die. Because if you look at it, it's really contradicted. You know, you can celebrate two sides. You celebrate me going, you celebrate me coming back. So which one is it? You wanted me to go, you know, you want me to come back. Which one you want? A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. The devil on his ground. Wake up, mighty people. 22 minutes past 8 o'clock. And some people been doing things for so long that it hurt their feelings that, oh, after the, you know, how do I stop this, you know, everybody know I'm doing this, or, you know, how do I stop this, how do I tell them I no longer want to do this, how do I tell them I don't want to do this no more, how do I stop smoking these drugs, you know, all my friends do it, you know, it's like, how do I stop, you know, everybody gonna think I'm soft, you know, I'm, you know, how do you start going to church, I mean, everybody gonna see me going to church now, how do I do it, all my friends is still in the gang banging, whatever, I gotta do what they're doing now, that's my boys, you know what I mean, how do I stop? That's human. That's this is what we gotta defeat. We gotta defeat that, and we gotta be mature enough to say, look, I don't care about you. I don't care what you think about it. I'm gonna do what's right for me. I don't care what you feel about it. And many times in life, a lot of things are keeping people from coming to the Lord because of all those kind of things that they're looking at. They're looking back at what my friend's gonna think. So what this person gonna think about me? They're gonna think I'm soft. They're gonna think I'm no longer this. That's their business. That's their business. The devil is working every way he can to stop you from coming to Christ and making you feel that you're going to give up all this. You know what I mean? But the secret is when you come to Christ, you realize you didn't need all these things all along. You didn't need all these things. But the devil will make you believe that coming to Christ is such a big deal. That's why people say, oh, well, after I'm this and that, then I'm going to come to Christ. Oh, I'm going to live my life. I'm young. I'm going to do this. Then I'm going to come to Christ. But you don't realize when you come to Christ, your life is going to be much more fulfilled from the beginning. Don't care, young or old. When you come to Christ, it's a more fulfilled life in Christ. But the devil wants you to believe that coming to Christ is a big burden. Oh, man, you're going to miss out on all this. Oh, what your friend's going to say. Oh, what's it going to look? Oh, you're going to be going to church now. Oh, walking with a Bible in your hand. How are you going to look coming down the street, man? Come on, man. Guy's going to think, oh, man, you know, yo, come on, man. You a Mac Daddy. Oh, you the man. Oh, how are you going to look? That's the devil. That's the devil. He's been doing it all the way he can. Anyhow the devil could find to stop people from coming to Christ, he's going to use every tool he can. Hallelujah. He's seeking whom he may devour. Whoever, in whatever way he can devour. That is what he's going to do all the time. Anyhow he's going to do it, he is going to do it. But you got to rise up and say, you know what? This is my life and I'm going to defend it. I'm going to search my heart and I'm going to come. I'm going to receive Jesus. I'm going to walk in the newness of life. I'm going to be transformed. I'm going to put on the new man. I'm going to let this old man die. And this is what we continue to preach on Choice Radio. Let that old man die. Let him die. Let him go. That we can arise with Christ. Glory to the name of Jesus, the great almighty King. Yes. 25 minutes past 8. I know this talk is hurting some of you. Touching your stomach. Careful you don't fall down, you know. Thank you, Jesus. Arise in the morning.
I will speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough. I will speak of your glory. I will show forth.
And the plus said everywhere, Good Friday.
If I dance,
so if the devil is saying, you see, they're saying it's good. All of them saying it's good. Hey, it's good. Everybody's saying it's good.
I say every space of your glory and the earth of your beauty. Your love is new every morning and your faithfulness is never shown. For you are the great and mighty God, so greatly to be praised. Your beautiful voice in the wind.
347-663-8638. If you got a testimony, feel free to share it with us, all right? Share it with your neighbor. He said we overcome him by the word of our testimony. It's important that you testify the goodness of your Father when he have done something for you. Let the whole world know you receive it in the name of Jesus.
Before him,
if you have received him this morning, just bow before the King right now. Bow before him. Glory to Jesus. Woo! Bow before him. Bow before him. Glory. Oh, okay.
Joy of the world, you are the greatest mighty God. So with
347-663-8638. That's the number for the inside if you have a comment. If you have a testimony, you have a scripture you want to share. It's a rise in the morning as we lift up and encourage the Christian family to keep moving on with Jesus. Yes. Keep going on. Deeper depths, higher heights. He's Lord and he's coming back soon. For our church that is ready. Brother Gene.
Jesus, my Lord. Jesus, my Lord. Jesus, my Lord.
You are the joy of the whole world.
Hallelujah, Jesus, indeed. The power of indoctrination, the danger of it. Dangerous, 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 dangerous stuff that we dealing with. Dangerous, dangerous. And we must understand where we are, who we are in the equation of life. We must know if he has chosen us in this generation to go on to glory land, we must be ready with a mind that understands all the implications. Glory to the name of Jesus. I know sometimes I say certain stuff, people, you know, you just can't take it that way because your stomach can't take it, but we must take it for what it is, like I said, you know what I mean? If you're out there and, you know, you want to share something, but like I said, it should be a commemoration. Commemorate. We commemorate in solidarity. We stand at ease. Hallelujah. As we reflect on what took place for our redemption. When he arose, now we are jubilant. Now we are going, hallelujah, now. Now we gone off. Now we gone off. Amen. But we cannot do things at the same time. It makes us double-minded. We don't know which one we want. Are you going to celebrate me going and celebrate me coming back? So which one? You want me to go, don't come back, or come back and don't go? Which one you want? Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to the name of the Lord.
You are our enemy. I worship you today.
We don't have to take those things personal, you know what I mean? Go to your Lord and Savior and ask him to explain it. Ask him for clarity, confirmation.
Heaven's peace of your glory and the end of your beauty.
And all the big publications that you see going on about this, it's not from the church. It's not from the Church of Jesus Christ. The world is quick to put this on there. Oh, Good Friday. The devil and the crowd. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
For you are a great and mighty God.
They will put this out for free.
Your beautiful situation. You are the joy of the whole world. For you are a great and mighty God. So greatly to be free. Your beautiful situation.
Good morning, Brother Clarence. If you got a testimony, don't be shy. Oh, this can play all day, right? Yeah. Running to my beautiful wife. Thank you, Lord Jesus. It's a dying morning. Joy of the whole world, indeed, as we go to the phone line. Caller, good morning.
Yeah, man, it's a Stricker.
Yes, sir, how you doing, brother? Good morning.
good morning. Better known as Davlo. Good morning. You know, I listen to you, and I pray God that you're very sincere. Your song's sincere, and I pray God that you are sincere. Now, one of the things that bothers me a bit with you, I think you criticize a little too much when you're on the radio. If you concentrate on the scripture and you concentrate on the meaning of things, or the meaning of words, I think you should do better than just criticizing. Thank God for life and the Spirit of God that you understand. Now, let me explain something to you. You start talking about Good Friday, and what's so good about Good Friday? I'll tell you what's good about Good Friday. If Jesus Christ didn't die for you on the cross on Good Friday, you wouldn't be saved. So for you, it's good. For Christ, it might not have been good because he suffered. But for you and for me and for everybody else, every Christian who was saved, it is a good day. It is a promising day. Nobody celebrate. Nobody going to party on Good Friday. Nobody going to party on Holy Saturday. Nobody should be going to party during the Lenten season. Not even the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Not even Easter Sunday. The thing about it is, you must try to understand a little more. You're just in the business. A lot of people get in the business for money and monetary purposes. I don't think you do or you are, because you talk about it, you know. But you know this Christian faith. Our Christian faith is more decisive. Separating people, separating churches, separating Christians. We just don't even understand. We're not even able to interpret the scriptures correctly. That's why we have so much division in the faith. And I think you should take some time and do less criticism and do more, you know, speak more positive about things. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Have a great day to my brother, in Jesus' name. Thank you. Glory to the name of the Lord. 37 minutes past the 8. As we lift up the name that is above every name, Jesus. At that name, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God. Thank you, Jesus. Voice of the man, Joe Praise. If you got a testimony, share it with us this morning as we lift up the name that is above every name. The name Jesus.
I will speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough. I will speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough.
Be your name, Jesus. In the book of Matthew 10 and 34, think not that I come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. For I am come to set a man at variance against his father, and a daughter against his mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And a man's foe shall be they of his own household. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh up not his cross and followeth after me, he is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it. And he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. Glory to the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Matthew 7 and 13. Enter ye at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, broad is the way that leadeth into destruction, and many there he which go in through it. Because straight is the gate, narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. For the one inside the morning time, arise in the morning. Yeah, thank you, my brother, for listening. I'm glad that you enjoyed the program. Matthew 7:21. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of the Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils? And in thy name done many wonderful works? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. I'm playing that one more time. That's going to be the theme this morning so far. Indeed, this beautiful song in the name of Jesus. 42 minutes after 8 o'clock. He said he came with a soda. Let's go back to the phone line. Hey, caller, good morning.
Grace and peace unto you, Minister Straker.
Grace and peace unto you, my sister. How are you doing?
May God continue to bless you as you do good work. I'm blessed and highly favored.
Yes.
I want to read from 2 Thessalonians.
Yes.
I'm going to read the preview before. It says, shortly after he wrote 1 Thessalonians, Paul heard that the people in Thessalonica were still having problems concerning the return of Christ. Some of them were thinking that the day of the Lord had already come. So Paul wrote this second letter to correct that misconception. There are certain things that must happen yet before Christ returns. Paul wrote, a falling away will occur. The man of sin will be revealed. The one who now holds lawlessness back will be taken out of the way. There will be signs and lying wonders, and God will send a strong delusion upon those who refuse to love the truth. Christians should not expect the Lord to return until these things have occurred. In the meantime, Christians must work diligently to earn the bread they eat. Okay, chapter 1. Paul and Silvanus and Timotheus unto the church of Thessalonica, Thessalonians, in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We are bound to thank God always for you, brethren, and it is meet, because that your faith groweth exceedingly, and the charity of every one of you all towards each other aboundeth, so that we ourselves glory in you in the churches of God for your patience and faith in all your persecution and tribulation that ye endure, which is a manifest token of the righteous judgment of God, that ye may be counted worthy of the kingdom of God, for which ye also suffer, seeing it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that troubled you. And to you who are troubled, rest with us, when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels, in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God, and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord, and from the glory of his power, when he shall come to be glorified in his saints, and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. Wherefore also we pray always for you, that our God would count you worthy of the calling, and fulfill all the good pleasure of his goodness, and the work of faith with power, that the name of our Lord Jesus Christ may be glorified in you, and ye in him, according to the grace of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
This Amen. Is the word of the Lord, my sister. Before you get off the phone, in terms of some statements I've made this morning, I guess you are listening to the program very attentively, and you have saw it fit to call and give us this from this reading right here. What I said this morning, and it's not something to take back and to reiterate. It's clearly stated. I'm saying that can somebody celebrate your death and still celebrate your resurrection and have this and be the same? Talk to me.
Celebrate
death. Yeah, can you celebrate the death of Christ and still say you're celebrating the resurrection of the same person, if you understand what I'm saying? You're thinking about it, and you're thinking
yes,
about
I'm
it.
Thinking about
guess
it,
what?
Yeah.
And guess what happened? You have a right to think about it. And this is how the carnal man and the regular man think about it. Now we have the result of what Christ died for. We are able to say, yes, we are happy that he did it. But before he had done it, everyone who was there with him could not have celebrated with him, knowing that they were going to crucify him. You understand what I'm saying? So now we who are of him and who are a part of him, we are in same solidarity with him, commemorating him in solidarity with him before he is crucified. When he has risen now, we know that he has risen to justify us. So now we can celebrate because now we have the finished product. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
Hallelujah. So this is what I'm saying. So this is what I'm saying. And if you understand the picture, what I'm saying, many of the times we are so caught up with things that we learn from a child, and we get into it and we go, and we don't even realize how devastating it is. A double-minded man is unstable in all his way. You can't celebrate me going and celebrate me coming in and have the same effect. You're going to have to either celebrate one more than the other. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
So so this is what I'm stating here, right here, and it's very clear if we all pay attention in the spiritual realm of it. If we pay attention, now we could talk about we celebrating because we understand what Christ did, but we cannot celebrate he going to die. We have to be in solidarity with those of the who were mourning for him at the time. It's only God who knew the future of what's going to happen from what he was going to do. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So whenever that time come around, we are in commemoration. We are in solidarity. We can say we're celebrating it. So why would that day be good? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
The result of it is good. The result of it is good. So we celebrate the result. But look at this reading right here. 1 Corinthians 2 and 9. But as it is written, I had not seen nor ears heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God had prepared for them that love him. But God had revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of a man,
save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man but the spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. Which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. Hallelujah. Let us give him praise, my sister.
Amen, amen, amen.
Thank you for the word.
Yes, once you have the Spirit of God, you're going to be able to discern spiritual things. And you're going to be able to receive spiritual things. You're going to be able to accept spiritual things. But if you don't have the Spirit of God, then you know you want to fight against those things.
Glory. Thank you, my sister.
Amen.
Be blessed. Yes. The time is fastly creeping by. Glory to the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Thank you for your son.
I will speak of your glory. I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough.
347-663-8638 if you're out there. If you get in there for 9, you're almost late.
I will show forth your beauty. If I dance, it will be enough. And if I shout, it will be enough.
Glory to the name of Jesus. And you see the thing about mankind, mankind have so much of feelings in them. We have so much of emotion that even if, you know, even if the revelation comes to somebody and they feel it's going to offend the congregation, you know, like as a leader, he's not going to even do it because he's feeling, well, man, I'm going to lose all my people. If God speak to you and God tell you something or his spirit, you know, just because everybody doing something, you don't have to do it with them. No, if God call you, God call you. If God chose you to share, to show you something, he show you something. If you could receive it, you receive it. If you can't receive it, you can't receive it. And we understand that many things people cannot receive. If the truth is right before your eyes and you just can't take it because you've been doing this thing for so long, everybody know I'm doing this thing, you know, it's just like one of the things that I research and check it out, when one of the guys from Ethiopia went to some place in Jamaica, and he went to tell the Rastafarian that, you know, Haile Selassie don't want you to worship him as no God, because he is not God, and he worshiped the real Almighty God. Those guys couldn't take it. They chased the guy out. They chased him away. And that's reality. You could go on YouTube and check it out. You could research it, check it out, and see what I'm saying. And that's the reality of human being. We are so puffed up in ourselves that when we get the truth, you know, we've been doing some things for so long, and you know, based on who we are and our education, and you know, we just feel that I can't receive this. I rather just go out the other way. I rather fight it all the way. You know what I mean? You with a man, and he said, look, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. And you just feel, no, I cannot let this happen. I'm going to fight all the way to the ground. I just told you my mind is made up. I want a divorce. I'm going away. I'm doing this, I'm doing this. No, you just feel, well, what would my neighbor say? What would my friend say? What would my mother say? What would my father say? How would I look in the community? What it is? That's human being. That's how we function. That's how we are. That's how we are. Instead of you receive the truth, absorb it, take it, shock it, move it back out, breathe it out, and glow in the newness of life. No, human being don't want to do that. Human beings don't want to do that. No, they don't want to do that. They rather go down with the fire. Say, no, we're going to fight this thing in court. We're going to fight this here. We're going to fight it there. I'm going to try to get rid of you. I'm going to do this to you. I'm going to do that to you. I'm going to go here. You know, amen. Hello, good morning.
Hello. Hello.
Good morning, sir. How are you doing?
I am blessed and highly favored.
Glory.
I want to say something to you, and I want to take it in the right spirit.
Frame of mind in the right spirit, right. I'm
giving it.
Yes.
It's not a criticism, it's a critique. I believe that you are a good brother. I believe that you mean well. But I believe that sometimes, as one other person said, you are overly critical. And the Bible says that people are going to come to Christ not based on the criticism that we make. People will come to Christ by the magnitude of all lifting up Jesus. And I believe if you lift up Jesus more, it'll be better. It'll be a better testimony for Choice Radio. That's the first thing. I'm not saying that you cannot be critical. It should be more of a critique. But I'm saying that it would be better if you lift up the name of Jesus more. Be more positive. Talk about the goodness of God, like you were having people call and testify this morning. That is a good thing. Have people talk about the goodness of God. I think that's
paramount.
Better.
Paramount, right?
Hello.
I said that's paramount. That would be paramount.
But I believe that's what it is. Okay. He says, if you lift
me up,
I will draw all men unto me.
Glory.
If you lift up the name of Jesus, you have a forum. Mm-hmm. That others would love to have. And while it is good to be critical sometimes you have to forget your own personal feelings and just lift up the name of Jesus.
So let me say this to you. What's your testimony of Jesus this morning? What is your testimony?
I'm going to give you a testimony, but don't push me. I'm going to give you a testimony. Mm-hmm. But I need to deal with some stuff first. All right, the second thing is, you're talking about how can a man celebrate death and then celebrate the resurrection. Well, let me tell you something for me. I can't tell you what to do, but for me, I will celebrate not Good Friday, because I don't believe he was crucified on a Friday anyhow, but I will celebrate the death of Jesus, because to me, the death is not only about him dying, but the cross is about victory and about life. So I will celebrate, and I will rejoice. I will give him glory. I will give him praise, because I understand the atoning work of the cross of Calvary. I understand that without the shedding of blood, there could be no remission for sins. I will also celebrate the resurrection, because I know it epitomizes the hope of the church. I know that because he was the first fruit, the first of those who rose from the dead, I too will rise one day. If I am dead, I will rise. And if I am still alive, I will still rise, because I'll be caught up to meet him as he returns for his church. So it's not contradictory. It is not double-minded. It is understanding the work of the cross and the hope of the resurrection. Now, my testimony, sir, is that God, as a little boy, I always looked to my African ancestry, and I received a prophecy many, many years ago about me traveling to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ to the African continent. And God just provided everything. He made it possible. It was a miracle that I was able to go to the African continent, to the exact place where I dreamt of and where I had in my spirit that God was sending me. And I was able to travel there, declare the word of the Lord, and return safely. That's one of my testimonies.
Amen. We give him praise. Hallelujah.
Please, sir.
Definitely.
You have a wonderful forum, man. make the most of it, man.
My brother, let me say this to you. I thank you for your call. I thank you for your comment. And I thank you for what you have stated. What you have stated, they are credible based on the way you put it and what you applied with it. As you said clearly, you have your opinion and I have my opinion. We all have our opinion. Also, we know from whence we came and we know who have called us and we know whose we are. You see what I'm saying? So you have your testimony. You know who called you. I know who called me. We all work in the vineyard for the same master. Hallelujah. We all come from a different area. And if we pay attention and listen to what is being stated, then we can come up with a better way to figure out, are we on the same team or are we not on the same team? What you said, you're talking about the power of the cross and you added that to show, to say, to come in with your commemoration and even to your celebration of the cross. What I am saying is, and I will continue to state it because it's deeply in my spirit, as to people talking about celebrating what they didn't know was going to be the future of the cross and what the cross was going to do. Hold on. Listen to you talk. You're saying you're my brother. I listened to you for a long while, and you spoke.
You can't come from that angle because that has nothing to do with us. We are here now. We are after the fact. We can't speculate as to what we would have done before because we weren't there. That does not apply to us, my brother.
Okay, let me ask you something. Let me ask you something now. As you talking like that. Resurrection. When the resurrection happened, were you there?
Oh my God.
We are both after it. We are both after the resurrection. But the point I'm trying to tell you, when the day come around, when they look at that day that happened, I'm saying we are in commemoration. We are in solidarity with those who are mourning for him. We know the outcome. We're celebrating the outcome. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Solidarity with those who mourn? Because I'm not mourning. I don't stand in solidarity with who mourn. There's no reason for me to mourn.
My brother, I understand your point, and your point is well taken. Your point is well made, and I receive it in the name of Jesus. I thank you for your contribution. I thank you for your testimony and all that you have stated. And if you see something critical and you see it in the way you see it, hey. You know, I mean, we lift up Jesus on Choice Radio. So you're talking about more lifting up and more lifting up, and you call to make a criticism, then make a testimony. Why didn't you just call and make your testimony? If you love the Lord so much, why didn't you just call and make your testimony?
That's how I take it. It was a critique. It was not criticism. I told you that. There is a difference between criticism and critiquing. And all I simply said to you, take it in the spirit in which it was given.
I do take it in the spirit.
I know you do it all the time, but you don't have to lash back at me.
No, I'm not lashing back at you. I'm stating what I'm stating because I'm saying based on how you called, okay, we call in for testimony. You a child of God. Why were you just on your heart to say, Jesus has done this for me, and God to the glory and call and just say, okay, you know, you call in for testimony, nobody call in, but I will call right now because I am a child of God, and I just love the Lord, and I'm going to give my testimony. And after I give my testimony, I will make my comment, or I will tell the brother something, or I will take him off the air, and I will say, brother, well, you know, what I think is this, and this, and this, and this, and this. No, you came with this, and I say, well, okay, give your testimony, then you give your testimony. But I'm saying, if you're in the... Hold on. If you're in the same spirit as I am, in the spirit of Jesus, as you saying we should lift up more Jesus, hallelujah, you saying we should lift up more Jesus, yes, we lift up a lot of Jesus. We have to continue lifting up Jesus. That's what we do on Church Radio. But I'm saying to you, if you say you're not calling to be critical, or whatever you want to categorize your comment, you say, okay, brother, let me talk to you off the air. I am also a child of God, and you know I look at this that way and whatever, whatever. No, you call to make your statement, and then in your statement, I ask you, where is your testimony? And you tell me, yes, I'm going to make a testimony. Your testimony should be first. Let me testify of the goodness of God. Let me testify because you there listening and you hear me calling for testimonies. If you are a child of God, stand up, testify, proclaim him. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus.
Thank you, sir. I am sorry that I didn't testify first. I am so sorry that you would have preferred me to tell you over the air, but I thought that it would have been better because the criticism went over the air. However, I am so sorry. It was never meant to upset you. It was just...
I'm not upset, critique, brother.
And it was not... And it I'm was not upset. Criticism. So I'm sorry that I didn't say to you over the air. And anybody who's offended because I spoke to you over the air, please forgive me. It was not my intention to upset anybody. I just was feeling very, very disturbed in my spirit because I believe that you've been given a forum, and I believe that I said it already. I wouldn't repeat it again over the air because you said I should have said it to you off air. And so I know the next time if there's an issue I have, I will speak to you off air, which is what you prefer. So again, my brother, I am sorry. Please forgive me. I should have testified first and then make my comments to you over the air. But I'm asking you just to forgive me if you're offended by that. Anybody else in Radio Land, if you were offended or thought that I offended 007 by speaking to him on the air, I'm asking you please to forgive me. All right?
My brother, you're forgiven. And like I said, you probably receive it back a little kind of, you know, the same way kind of came across. But, you know, brother, we all in Jesus Christ, amen? And we know what he did for us and we understand where we're coming from. And, you know, he said that we all are given different role to play in this kingdom. Let me say this to you, my brother, before you get off the air. There are so many things going on that will affect the body of Christ that is not spoken about. People don't talk about it. There is an area when we talk and we evangelize to get people in the kingdom. But the people who are in the kingdom also need to be solidified with information as to the changing of the times and the changing of the world and the dimension that things are going now. You know, there are so many things going on that will affect the walk of the Christian who are already in Christ that we have to talk about to update the body who are already in Christ, that we can make them more solid to stand on a rock and to know that different things are coming to shake them off or their platform with Christ. So there are many times we have to come with situations that is important. It doesn't have to be always calling to the sinner to come home or talking about this, but we must have to do what has to be done to make the believer stronger in Christ. So there is areas that will come up when we have to say stuff that is critical from a certain area. So we come and we do whatever, but we must attack and deal with certain situation. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I don't deny that. But there is a, in my view, there is a time and a place for certain things. Can I say something to you off the air?
Hold the phone, my brother. Thank you. Yes, all right.
Every morning, and your faithfulness is never shown. ever shone.
I see every space of your glory and the edge of your beauty. Your love is new every morning and your preference is ever shown. For you are the great and mighty God, so greatly to be praised. Your beautiful voice in the wind, you are the joy of the whole world. For you are the great and mighty God, so greatly to be praised. Your beautiful voice in the
the joy of the whole world. 18 minutes on the other side of the 9. It is a beautiful morning in the land of the living, guys, and we continue to give thanks as we arise in the morning. And all, we thank you for listening, everybody on the outside in Choice Radio. We just give him praise. And let me thank my brother there, that pastor that called me up. Thank you, pastor, for calling me. We had a very nice discussion there, and you know, we give praise for all those who are listening and all those who have good intention for us as we continue to do this together. We all have a part to play in the kingdom, and like I said, we're going to do what God has placed in us, that we can continue to be a light to this fallen world right now in the name of Jesus. Caller, good morning.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Good morning. How are you doing?
My name is Sister Maria, a brother Kent.
How are you doing, Sister Maria?
I'm blessed and highly favored. I think the man of God called earlier at, it so happened I kind of turned on the radio and... the man of God who called earlier sounds like he must have been in the ministry for a long time and sounds like he has been traveling and doing the Lord's work. But sometimes when we are on the media, we have to use the spirit of discernment, what we say and how we say. because all of us have a different walk than the devil with God. Am I correct in saying that?
We are absolutely correct, my sister. Let me say this to you. God has given me this right here that I know that I know that I know. When a caller call me, hallelujah, I'm ready. I know what's coming next. I'm just, my spirit just tell me, get ready for this one. Battle in your seatbelt, get ready. That's it, get ready. If I choose, listen to me. If I choose to put every single person that's going to raise some kind of red flag on Choice Radio off the air, you would never hear them on the air if I am walking in the spirit. If I come into this radio, my sister, and I say, Lord, I'm walking in the spirit today. Glory to your name, Jesus. And this phone ring, certain people would never be on the radio. You never hear them if that is my plan. Because that is how real God is. Whenever a caller call me, I get it. I'm ready. The spirit race up. It race up. It ready. My head start to go because it's ready. I start getting scriptures ready. I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready. This is the Lord that we're talking about. Glory to the name of Jesus. Because we know what he has implanted in us. Glory to the name of Jesus. You hear what I'm saying, my sister? If I decide to take every single caller that's going to raise something that is contrary or contradicting or will go song anyway to what is going on, I can say, look, this one is not going to be on the air. That one would not be on the air. That is the way the spirit, that's how intense the spirit is and how real the spirit is, my sister.
Minister Stricker, what I'm about to say is not to defend you or to bring the man of God down. I am going to speak as the Spirit of the Lord leads. I know where and how the pastor, the man of God, came about on the radio. I do understand. But he is also on need to understand that we are in a forum where we have believers, we have pastors, bishops, and unbelievers. Now, coming on the air and giving a criticism, a critic is not a forum, because now what happens to the unsaved and those who are listening, it sounds like, oh, we are fighting for the gospel, who is right and who is wrong. Now, because I have been listening to you, because you, where you have came from, where the Lord has taken you and where the Lord is taking you, I see you as John the Baptist. John the Baptist cried out in the wilderness and he said, repent, repent, repent. The Lord is coming. That is your message in every time I listen to this. But unfortunately, many churches do not talk about repentance. God, yes, we have to talk about the cross. That is the Lord himself, the cross. But if you don't repent, repentance is a must. Salvation, repentance, and coming of the Lord is a must. And which you speak all the time with backing up with the scripture. And you are absolutely doing what you are doing as for you are called to do in the kingdom purpose. But you have to also are ready to get all kinds of opinions and all that, but different of them. For example, my level with the Lord is different from your level, because you and I have similar kind of calling to go out on the street and tell people to repent or salvation. I understand where you're coming from, but sometimes when we have the teachers and the leaders of the church coming and saying this, they have to use the spirit of discernment. They are right from their level, the way they've been trained, the way they have been experienced with the Lord and all that. He's not wrong either, but we have to understand where we stand in the body of Christ. Am I right?
We are totally correct, my sister. And that's why I say we all have to listen to what each other is saying and try to understand the perspective in what we're saying. Because what he's saying is the same thing I'm saying too. I'm just talking and saying that we cannot do these two things and claim it in both areas, from the starting and the finish. Amen. And we understand, we're saying that this thing already happened, so it already happened, so now we are happy that it happened. We all are happy that Jesus went on the cross.
As for your topic today, in my own understanding, as I'm led by the Spirit of Lord, because Jesus died and resurrected, I can face tomorrow. I am rejoicing because he died and he's resurrected. That's the very reason why it should not only be today, it should be every day to remember that Jesus died and rise for me. Now, yes, we go to church. We go to church not because of Thanksgiving or that. Our Thanksgiving has to be every day in our life. The very fact that Jesus went and died and resurrected, this is what the remembrance has to be for all of us. That is how, this is why I go to church. This is how I commemorate the living God who died for my sin. But Jesus also said, Lord said, destroy the temple in 3 days, I will rebuild it again. Like you said, God knows what he's doing. But it is not in a human perception to understand what God is doing next unless the Spirit reveals to us. So this is my opinion, but it is, I would say honestly, because the man of God called, it was a kind of destruction in the flow of the Spirit of the Lord. For stuff like this, it should be taken later, or he could have meet you personally, tell you this, because I do, even in my field, I kind of feel kind of distracted, because the flow that you were going from morning until now, it was wonderful. You were but don't lose your joy, my brother.
No, hold on.
don't lose your joy.
Listen to me. Hold on. Let me say this to you, my brother, my sister. One thing I could tell you, God know every person that is listening to the radio. He know Amen. Everybody who is listening. And somebody might feel they called to do something, and God is telling them, look, you better get yourself together before I shake you up. That's how God is. God is going to use any way he can to make sure he get to you. And this is what it is. God know who listening to the radio. I could have come here and just decide to do something and just, you know, say this and say this. Whatever. God know who listening to the radio. God know who is listening to the radio. And what I also said, my sister, anything I'm saying that we can validate in the scripture to be in alignment with what I'm talking, or to be in accordance with what I'm talking. I read in Matthew when we're talking about Mary and the disciples were there with Jesus, and they were there. And we're talking about the commemorating, standing in solidarity with them at that time. And then we Amen. Are going to rejoice after he had paid the price, divine justice, and he raised up. Now we're celebrating the resurrection. You see what I'm saying? So this is what I'm saying overall. So we both on the same path. We understand the power of the cross. But we say we stand in solidarity before he go there. Even if it happened already. The point is, now that we have the result, we know why he died. So we say we're happy that he died. Yes. But we don't celebrate nobody death. It's to say we celebrate the death. We celebrate the complete package.
I agree with you. I think also the man of God also addressed that you said you are harsh on
pastors,
on people of what you say. But here's the thing: God is also merciful, but we also cannot let the wrath of God fall upon the children of disobedience. So repentance must be preached. We are so into confined mode that we even forget that without repentance you cannot make it to heaven. Salvation, repentance, and coming of Jesus Christ must be preached in this time, because we are living in a later time. So what you're doing is a wonderful job. Keep it up, but keep on preaching the repentance, because unless we repent, likewise we will perish. So we can be anybody. We can be the head of the church. We can be bishop. We can be missionary. We can be anybody, but unless the repentance is preached, we cannot make it to heaven.
We cannot.
This is my contribution.
I thank you for your contribution, my sister, and we continue to relate to the scripture. He said in Matthew 10:34, he said, Think not that I come to send peace on earth, but I come to send, I come but a sword. Amen. For I am come to set a man at variance against the father, and the daughter against the mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. The thing about it is, we have to understand is that there are so many forces working on all different levels. And we have to remember that the Bible said, look, he's seeking whoever he may devour. So if he could get anybody to come into your good spirit and trying to make something look like it's not that, you know, big deal to say that or whatever, and get you into them to believe or to be on another side, to go away from the gospel, he's going to do it. That's what the devil been doing all along. Anybody he can get to go in and infiltrate, the devil is going to do it. That is what the devil is doing. You see what I'm saying? So I
of
think,
course, he's called the prince of the air. He controls the principality. That's why we have to, at all times, we have to be prayed up. We have to pray and constantly be in the presence of God.
Of the Lord.
Because when we are close to God, the devil will run away. But if you are not, that's why prayer is the key. Prayer is the weapon against all evil.
Glory.
Because until, and also, the one enemy, no enemy is a powerful, I won't even say his name, powerful is a, devil is a powerful being. It cannot be taken lightly. That's why we have to always be in prayer and supplication, and also be near the cross, so that we can overcome with the blood of the Lamb and the testimony of what Lord did in our life. Amen.
Amen and amen. Thank you, my sister, in the name of Jesus.
Bless my brother, and keep doing the Lord's work. You know who you are in the Lord. You know whose you are, and keep using the Holy Spirit, who
Hallelujah.
Is the guide and revealer. And as for the leading of the Holy Spirit, do what you must do for the glory of God.
Thank
amen.
You, Jesus. Thank you, my sister, indeed. And like I said, you know, personally for me, we all who do the gospel, we all should be in one accord for the honor and glory of the word of God. That it's, once what we're saying can be validated in the book, we can look and see what we're saying there. We must align with it and be right with it. And that's important for every listener to understand. If you're a believer in Christ Jesus, we have to. Don't care how offensive some things might come across. Once it can be stated and validated in the Word of God, we must be willing to humble ourselves to receive it. Amen? The devil would like it to be all just a party, 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 and no information and no serious conversation about salvation and the seriousness of what is going on. That's what the devil would like to take. That's why some people just get on and oh, hallelujah, playing all this song, and they jump around in Jesus, and they thank you in Jesus. Yeah, you could say that all you want, and there's no power in that. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Pastor.
Morning, sister. How are you doing?
Yeah, you are doing a wonderful work.
Thank you.
And how can you celebrate the death of someone when they're gone? You have to celebrate when you see them come back again. But my husband said to me, "So how can it be Good Friday when they killed Jesus?"
Well,
so bless everyone that called and brought those pastor that. You go and let them one criticize. You're doing a good work.
We give thanks, my sister. Thank you for your comment, and I appreciate it in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Amen.
Thank God.
All right. 33 minutes. And, you know, like I said, guys, we're not looking for you know, no puff up on. We're not looking for nothing like that. We're just saying, and I just want people to listen in the spirit of what I was saying this morning. And I mentioned a couple things to really get into that area. I'm talking about indoctrination. We have learned certain things so long, it's so engraved in our system, that now that we come to a place where we can whatever, we still don't want to let it go, because we just feel, well, how do I get away from this? How do I do this? You know what I mean? It's a person like a person who had a bunch of money, and then all of a sudden they get broke. They rather kill themselves. How do they face people? How do you face life now? Everybody knew I was like this. How do I accept this truth? It's the same thing, the rich man, he went to Jesus, how do I get saved? And Jesus said to him, sell all your stuff and come. He walked away. He's like, man, you crazy. I can't do that. Caller, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I am blessed, thank God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. I just called to give my testimony. I just want to thank God for waking me up this morning, that I am not dead, and actually people thinking and mourning over me and wondering where I am, if I'm in heaven or in hell. But I thank God because I have that chance to continue lifting up His name, to continue magnifying and blessing Him, because He's my only God, my only God. And I thank Him for all He has done in my life. And with saying this, I just want to say, because, you know, at this present moment, right now, Good Friday, you know, a lot of people, they have all these big plans and all this celebration that they have going on, and they just do not want to just take a minute and stop and realize that, yes, this is the day that God, they crucified Him. Yes, He was crucified so that we can have that second chance to enter into His kingdom. But let's take that moment and rejoice in that He is alive. He is alive, and we can call upon His name. When we pray, we can pray in His name to our God. To God, we can pray in His name. And we have to thank Him for that. Other than just right now, with all those big plans going on and all those happy, because trust me, a lot of people, this is what they do not want to let go of, the partying, the plans that they have to celebrate the death of Christ. They do not want to let it go. But today is the day that we should rejoice in, that He is alive. Yes, He has paid the price. The price is paid, and now we are rejoicing that He is a living God.
Thank you, my sister.
You're welcome.
All right. 36 minutes after 9 o'clock. It is Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Amen. And like I continue to say before, guys, everything that we do is for the honor and the glory of the name of Jesus. We know where Jesus has taken us from. Amen. And we understand what it is. We understand the fight. We understand what we're going to have to face. We know, those of us who have made up our mind to walk with the Lord and go straight, we understand what it's going to be. We know what it's about. Caller, good morning.
Hi, good morning, Minister Streak.
How are you doing, sir?
Very well. I must comment on something else. I was blessed by the program last night, you know, that whole discourse of Last Day stuff and what's happening with the new age movement and the church. It's very, very important. I don't know if other people are listening, but I tell you, man, wealth of information that I think is very, very necessary to be heard. All right. In addition to that, I just want to comment, you know, Jesus actually wants us to celebrate His death also. That's why He instituted a communion. And if you look in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter, I think it's 11. Well, I don't want to say think. Yes, it's 1 Corinthians 11 verse, you know, 24, 25, going on to 26. We'll see that after the Lord, the apostle said, or the, quoting from the gospel, of course, "Take ye, this is my body which was broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same manner, he took the cup and he did the same thing. And then verse 26 said, as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes. And then proclaim also means you show the Lord's death, or you bring it into, you call it to mind, remembrance. You proclaim it, you tell it. You indicate it to others, you know, you make it known. So celebrating the Lord's death is something that God really wants us to do. And, you know, around this time, yeah, we know the world corrupts everything good anyway. The world is separated from God. Well, we were there and we know. But when so celebrating the death of Jesus Christ is basically, and resurrection and everything else, basically something that a Christian would do. That is those, the children of God, those who are born again. So the world will, you know, take this period, this time, to have a party, to get together, to have cake, and eat, you know, all the works. Whereas it's not about that. But Christians now, born again Christians who know better, No, definitely it's a time when more intensely you reflect on the death of Christ. Although all the time we're talking about the death of Christ, we always to witness the people, you must, that's included. So we're always talking about people. I mean, sorry, talking about the death of Jesus Christ, the resurrection of Jesus Christ, but this time it seems as though there is a principal focus there on the death and resurrection.
And the crucifixion.
And yeah, it's commemoration of that. Well, whoever created that, we didn't see that anywhere in the Bible where Jesus or the apostles say do that. But whoever brought this in, and we know who, brought that into existence, whatever they meant it to be, it don't have to be so for the church. We could stand and say, hey, well, this is a milestone in history that Jesus truly died, because there are some people who don't believe that Jesus really died. You know, and it's a good thing. Well, we have to commemorate the death and, you know, resurrection of Christ. So it's a great thing. Anyhow, I'm just blessed by the programming. So keep up the good works.
So before you get off, so let me say this to you. I appreciate your contribution, always some great contribution. So how do we put in perspective the name Good Friday for good? Why good? Well, when he's dying, how is that good? And we don't have the outcome of it. I understand everything that you said. It makes sense and it sounds logical. You see, logic is something that always mankind, mind, you know, we always think on the logical explanation of what it sounds like. And it have that logical application to it. What you have mentioned about the Last Supper was the commemoration that, yeah, you know, his body was whatever. I'm talking about the crucifixion of Christ, he being crucified and being called, with you know, calling good to it. For those of us who are Christian, you know, we are enjoying the result of the crucifixion.
Yep. Well, you know, first of all, it's some paradoxical, because we can't, one wouldn't want to say, well, the death of someone must, the day of the death must be called a good day, regardless to the benefits that come, right? But in the case of Jesus now, it's a good day when he died, because the whole human race was lost. And without his death, sacrificial death, as the Lamb of God, as God referred to him in his word, there won't be the remission of sins. We would be in our sins, and we would be bound for hell, eternal disaster. So the death of Jesus Christ, the day of his death, should not be called Bad Friday. As far as I'm concerned, the opposite of good is bad. What if it was called Bad Friday? Then we would be really going against the grain of prophecy, which indicated that since in the book of Genesis, as a matter of fact, at the fall of man, that the serpent will bruise his head, but he will bruise his heel. So Jesus, God had a plan all along, mm-hmm. Since at the fall of man, that this is going to happen, and it's a good thing. We think of death. We think of death sometimes as so evil and bad. But I mean, Jesus really went through excruciating pain. This is the kind of death, you know, that he suffered.
Right. So what I'm saying to you, I understand we all on the same one accord. We all in one accord. We all on the same page. You see, what I'm saying to you is, the church started when he rose. Man is redeemed when he rose. There is nothing to gain when he's dying, but when he has risen.
Well, he satisfied when he died.
What I'm saying, he satisfied divine justice when he arose to prove that he was who he say he was. So,
but he satisfied God's requirement for the penalty of sin, which is death.
That's great, yes, but that is for God.
But that's great. I mean, but that's essential.
Well, yes, it's essential, but I hope you understand the context in which I'm placing this.
I don't understand it yet, because the death of Jesus Christ is of paramount importance as much as his resurrection, because one doesn't go without the other. So it's just like a package.
Right, you see, this is what I'm saying.
You can't leave the death out. and see, well, let's talk about the resurrection alone, or focus on the resurrection.
You see,
because without the death of Jesus Christ, there is no remission of sin, no shedding of blood. Right.
Right. So that is when you mention about the supper. The supper commemorates the death and resurrection as a package. That is what we're talking about. But I'm talking about when the time comes around, when people are celebrating the day when they crucified him, we standing in solidarity with those of us who were mourning with him at that time, because that is the day that we are reflecting on. We are not saying that all those things don't have the implication and all those things don't have the power, but we are standing in solidarity for those of us who gain something from his death. You see what I'm saying?
But you're saying we stand in solidarity with those who were there at the time in mourning for the death
right,
of Jesus?
Right. This is what
I don't think, well, you know, if the followers of Jesus Christ at the time, like Mary and Mary Magdalene and all the other people around, was actually, and the apostles too, and other disciples, they stood around and they saw the crucifixion. They were there. They witnessed everything.
And they were happy.
So now it was traumatic for them. But remember that to a large extent, a lot of them still did not come to grips with the fact that Jesus really had to go through this.
This is what we're talking about. We are talking from behind. We are talking from the front of the story. We are not talking behind the story. We cannot mix behind the story and in front of the story and get the same result. When that day comes, like a man's birthday, people celebrate when you were born. That is your birthday. You are not in that same state anymore. You are an adult. You are where you are. But when you were born, people celebrate your birthday as you are born. So people celebrate that time when you came into the world. So that's what I'm saying to you. The same application cannot be applied. And look at the scripture right here. And talking about, howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princesses of this world that come to naught. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory. So like I said, logically, it making sense to say, well, okay, it makes sense because if he didn't die, he couldn't raise. And we understand all that application. But I'm saying the resurrection time cannot be a happy time if we are in commemoration with those who gain from it. Those who was in solidarity with Christ all along, who were followers of him. You see, this is what I'm trying to say. So he's not saying that there is no power in the both side of it. But to celebrate me dying and still celebrate me rising, it's really and truly, it's like they cannot go together. We understand the power of it. We understand the power in it. We understand the capability of the dead to make the resurrection being what it is. But if you say, I'm celebrating that you're dying today, let's celebrate your dead. We're killing you today. I'm celebrating. Then when you are raised, I'm still celebrating again. Well, you're a crazy person. So which one you're really celebrating? So this is the key element I'm saying right here. If we're standing in commemoration, we stand in commemoration. We commemorate that time that he went to do that for us. So this is what I'm saying. So it makes sense.
Oh, that's what I'm saying too. I'm saying that it's a good thing to commemorate the death of Christ. As a matter of fact, that's a very, very, what is it, man? Hey, it's a critical thing to do, because in scripture all over, the new covenant is based on the death of Jesus and the resurrection. So we always, I mean, we commemorating that all the time. So this time, we're not mourning. I don't know. I know there are some religions under Christendom who mourn at this time.
Well, I don't see it as mourn. I mean, I'm talking about standing in solidarity. That's why we say commemorate.
But solidarity with who?
No, you're in solidarity with those of them who had followed him and believed in him before he went to be crucified. Because there were people who say, crucify him. And they were having joy that they were crucifying him. So they should be the one that's going to be happy because they got their requests fulfilled. Because they said to crucify him. So if you say it's a happy day for you, then you are with these people who say, yes, let's crucify him.
No, you can't look at it that way.
No. Well, listen to me. Listen to me. Hallowed be your name, Jesus. We give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory. I don't care where everybody coming from. Glory to the name of Jesus. Amen. We walk in the spirit and we don't walk in the flesh, and we don't walk in after the flesh. If anybody want to continue to walk after the flesh and believe they want to go along because everybody doing it, we're going to do it. Glory to the name of Jesus. Anybody could do what they want to do. Like I said to you personally, we cannot be celebrating the death of somebody and the resurrection of the same person. You will be a double-minded person because
Jesus is a unique case. You celebrate the death of Jesus Christ till he come by taking the communion, and even though you talk about the death of Jesus Christ, and it's a victory for human race in general. So that's a victory point, because without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Everybody bound for hell.
Hallelujah.
So then the people who give instructions to shout and say, crucify him, and they get their request fulfilled. They fulfill Bible prophecy without even knowing.
Even knowing, we understand that.
They cause the plan of God
to be fulfilled.
To come to pass, the fruition, without they even knowing it. And God always do that, you know.
Yes.
Even in these last days, you know.
Yeah.
The things that the world is doing, the governments of the world is doing, that they're not looking at Bible prophecy, but they're fulfilling prophecy, preparing the way for the Antichrist, you see?
Amen. Mm-hmm.
So what I'm saying is that those who shouted, crucify him, yes, they get a sense of satisfaction in seeing this guy who commit treason and who is claiming to be the Son of God die. Okay, but what was fulfilled in the process? The whole prophetic utterances given from Genesis come right down the line of Jesus, who came from eternity past and come into the flesh for the purpose of dying as the Lamb of God for the sins of the world. That came to pass. So when we celebrate, let's say Christians celebrate differently. When we celebrate the death of Jesus and say, hey, it's a good day when Jesus died. And if you call it Good Friday, I don't call it Good Friday. I don't even call it...
How do you call it?
I just celebrate the death of Jesus Christ. And if I have to refer it as Good Friday, I will say Good Friday. And that's not a problem. It's a matter of words.
Guess
and
what?
What I know it means.
Oh,
it's
a matter of words.
Good Friday, because Jesus laid the commemoration of the laying down of the life of Jesus as a sacrificial lamb for my sins and yours and for everyone else. So now, those who want to be foolish and say, well, we accomplished something. And Satan's still laughing, probably. I guess he's not laughing anymore because, you know, he got a dead blow. But the point is, there is no solidarity with those who had joy in his death.
No. I said solidarity with Mary. Solidarity with, that's what I'm talking about. We stand in solidarity with the Lord.
This is what I'm saying.
So if God
sent Jesus Christ for this purpose, and it's fulfilled. Man, it's hallelujah, glory to God for this great death of Jesus Christ, and death again. Listen, and death is not such a bad thing, because except for the lost person, right? But Jesus being God, death was not a big issue. The only thing I say is we have to appreciate the sacrificial death, because Jesus in human form really endured serious pain and suffering from the time of his arrest right on to the crucifixion. And when we go through pain and so on, we should really, it's unbearable sometimes, we should remember, oh boy, Jesus went through more than that. Could you believe the price he paid for our sins and appreciate it? Other than that, his transition from this life into the other life to the resurrected body, oh man, it's a blessing. It's a blessing. Going to the tomb, rising from the grave, and walking and moving again for 40 days and so on the earth.
Which part are you going to be more happy for? When he rising or when he dying? Which one are you going to laugh a little more, party a little harder for? Which one?
Well, I'm happy for both party of them equally.
So you put ten
you blow ten balloons
when he dying and 10 for when he raising.
You can't grade it by numbers. No, it's just that one can't do without the other.
I hear that.
The death precedes the resurrection.
Hallelujah.
And without without the death, there is no resurrection. Then without the resurrection, the death meant nothing. So
I understand you, my brother.
We stand on equal ground.
Amen. Thank you for the call, my brother. As
amen,
always.
Amen.
Yes, man.
All right.
Let's take one more call. Caller, good morning.
Good morning. I just want to say this topic. I'm here and I'm really thinking about this topic. You know, one thing I must say, it's kind of a little, I wouldn't say controversial, but
It's a mystery. Because one thing we have to remember, when crucifying Christ, the devil was happy. You know why? The devil was happy because he thought when God would have been crucified, it would have been finished. If he only knew it was to pay that price that we would be redeemed, they would not kill him. So what I'm saying is, are we happy because of the death? Because remember, the devil was happy. We are actually thankful. We are grateful. Right now, I am thankful for his death. I am grateful for his death, right? I'm happy that I have that chance to enter into the kingdom, because if he did not die, I would not enter into the kingdom. I am not rejoicing. I don't know how to put it. Maybe we are not coming with the right words, the right thing to say. Because when I look back, seriously, when I look back in terms of what I've read in the Bible, I read this was a secret that was hidden from man, from the devil. Because if the devil knew that they were crucifying Christ for this reason, he would not be there. And that the devil was happy at the time. So right now, I am not happy. I am just thankful and grateful for the death of Christ.
Thank you, my sister, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
All right, so definitely indeed, let me thank everybody for the contribution this morning. And you know, there are sometimes, you know, we have conversation that might really, you know, go a certain way, and, you know, but it's not our intention to create chaos and, you know, confusion and all this kind of stuff like that. I said, if we walk in the Spirit, we will adhere to the Spirit of God, and that's really what it is fundamentally. There are a lot of things that are sung in logical, just like people who celebrate, who do the Sabbath day, they said, because God doesn't change, and he gave the Sabbath day when he was creating the world, and he said he rested on the seventh day, people with that logics, they said, well, if he said that then, there is no way anything else happens after that. And those kind of things, like I said, they have their place, you know what I mean? But those things that we talk about, like I said, I'm very clear into what I'm trying to say, and we understand the power of the resurrection. We understand the power that the dead had done. We know what it is. Like I was just saying to you guys, those of us who call it a Good Friday, if we looking at what happened on that day, it cannot be seen as a good day for those of us who are enjoying the result of what happens by he being risen. That's what I'm saying. The people who were killing him on that day, they were rejoicing. The devil was rejoicing. He was thinking that he was getting rid of Christ, not knowing that he was actually fulfilling God's perfect plan by redeeming man through the death of Christ. But I'm saying, when the day when they try to go back, even though it's not the appropriate date, but when people go back to that date when that particular action of the crucifixion was taking place, those of us who stand in solidarity with his mother and everybody else who was around in the apostles and stuff like that, to say that we are happy while they at that time, because what we're celebrating is the time when it happened. We understand the result now. So we're talking because we know what it happened, what transpired from he dying. But we are not celebrating when he risen. We're celebrating the day that he was crucified. So how could, when you're celebrating the day that he was crucified, we know the result. And this, the Last Supper is talking about commemorating the package of the death and the resurrection, the blood that was shed for our redemption. And you eat this as you reflect on what the whole process, the package, death and resurrection, as often as you do this. So after it was done and completed, now on a daily basis, we celebrate the package. But if we have the date that is coming up saying that this day is when they crucified and killed him, we who are Christian in Christ, like I said, I'm saying the right and appropriate stance to be taken is a stance of solidarity, you know, with those of them who were experiencing pain at that time, not knowing what God had to do with he dying on the cross. So it's something very clear I'm saying right here. And like I said, every man will perceive it in his own spirit based on whatever spirit he's allowed to dominate him or to rule his his mind, perspective, or whatever it is. So every man have their own opinion, and nothing wrong with that, you know what I mean? And I was there, and the scripture just really came to me that this is what it write here. 1 Corinthians 2 and 6. I'm going to read it all the way down from 6 to 14. And we thank everyone for listening. We thank you for your patronage, everybody listening to Choice Radio. And we hope that we're not offending anyone. We're not intended to be offensive to anyone. But like I say, whatever I speak on the radio, if we can validate what I'm saying in the Word of God, if you are of Christ, we should be in one accord with it, regardless to what it make your flesh feel like, what it make you feel in your who you think you are. You must humble under the mighty hand of the Almighty God and let the word of the Lord cleanse and do what has to be done, that we can relate to the word and let the word be the word. Hallelujah. And not try to rise above the word of God, because the word of God is the power of God. Hallelujah be your name, Jesus. Thank you. He said in 2 Corinthians 2 and 6, howbeit, we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princesses of this world that come to naught. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom, which God ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princesses of this world knew, for had they knew it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, I had not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man, the things which God had prepared for them that love him. But God had revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of man, save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so, the things of God knoweth no man, but the Spirit of God. Now, we have received not the Spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. Which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things and spiritual. But the natural man receive not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he that is spiritual judgeth all things, yet he himself is judge of no man. For who had known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. The word of the Lord is already blessed in Radio Land. We give him praise, we give him thanks, we give him glory, we give him honor, because he's worthy to be praised. We thank him for where he has taken us and what he has done in our life. Everybody who has received Christ, we must acknowledge where we came from and continually look back and reflect on the power and the magnitude of the Jesus. The name that is above every name given among men, by which man can be saved. At that name, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God. Father, we thank you for each and every listener today, Almighty God. Father, we know that we don't speak of ourselves, but we speak of your power. We speak of your Son, Jesus, Almighty God. We pray that everyone who listened was edified, and everyone who listened gained something or came to a place that they would seek you more. They would seek more of your deep things that you want to relate to those of us who would like to walk in the Spirit. We thank you for your Holy Spirit, Almighty God. We thank you. We pray for our brothers and sisters out there in Radio Land, Lord, as you continue to reach out your hands to them in every way you can. Glory to your name. You are worthy to be praised. We thank you for salvation. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for Jesus. A man that knew no sin became sin for us. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallowed be your name, Lord Jesus. We thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. So as we shut down the phone line, we come to the conclusion. like I said before, I always say this, you know, many programs would not come the way you want it to be. They would not taste right in your mouth. But we just go to Him who give it liberally to all men and ask Him for confirmation in the Spirit. That's what He says. We all should study to show ourselves approved unto God. Not unto religion, not unto denomination, not unto groups of association, but unto God. He's mighty and worthy. You say, be transformed by the renewing of our mind. Let me say thank you to all the callers. Every caller who called today, guys, we thank you for your calls. We thank you for taking time out to call. Thank you for your bravery to call and share and impart some information. We thank you. We pray that you will continue to strive for the things of our Father, that we all can be in one accord in the name of Jesus. Amen. So we thank everybody for the contribution this morning. Okay? Every day I pray to be more humble and pray as He continue to mold and shape me. Thank you, Jesus.
In the years of your beauty, your love is new every morning. And your faithfulness is never shown. For you are the great and mighty God. So greatly to be praised. Your beautiful constellation. You are the joy of the whole world. For you are the great and mighty God. So greatly to be praised. Your beautiful constellation.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. If you've listened this morning and you enjoyed the music or something was said that touched your heart this morning, that you want to know more about Jesus, He's offering you an opportunity right now to get into the kingdom and come in and let Him turn your life around. Let Him change your heart and give you a heart of flesh. If you're out there in Radio Land and something touched you today, something that somebody said made you believe that there is really a God, and I need to find this Lord Jesus, I need to find Him, this is your opportunity right there. If you believe that there is a Lord, you believe that there is a God, you believe in Him and you want to receive Him right now, I'm going to give you an opportunity right here. I want you to say this prayer with me and believe it in your heart. And believe it deep inside. Lord Jesus, I know I am a sinner and I have displeased you in many ways. I believe you died for my sins. And only through faith in your death and resurrection can I be forgiven. I want to turn from my sins and ask you to come into my life as my Lord and Savior. From this day on, I will follow you by living a life that pleases you. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving me. Hallelujah. If you said this prayer, just by saying this prayer, a big, big work has started in you. A transformation, a circumcision inside of you that God is faithful to complete once you have started it. If you confess with your mouth and you believe your heart that Jesus is Lord. Amen. I encourage you to find a Bible-believing church where Jesus is the main course. Jesus is all day, all night. That's all they talk about is Jesus. Hallelujah. Find that church and continue to read your Bible. And ask the Lord to keep working on you. And He will continue to transform you. Alright? So just keep going on. Keep going on. Believe that He has done the work. Believe that He has forgiven you for all your sins. He's faithful to complete everything that He has started in every one of us. He has done it for me. And He can do it for you just the same way. Amen? He's a just God. Balance. All across the board. He's worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. All those on the phone line, good morning, thank you. Thank you for taking the time out. Yeah. proud to stand up with Jesus and stand up with the word of the Lord. Be proud to stand up and be separated. Broad is the road to destruction. Many, many will go there. What a team song this morning. What a team song. Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Father, we thank you for Jesus. Where would we be without Jesus? Where would we be? Would we ever be able to listen to such a program? Listen to those music? Talk about the Bible? If it wasn't for Jesus. Father, we thank you for Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Those who were rejoicing while they were killing him had no reason, had no clue what they were doing. The mighty power of the Almighty God. Glory. We know the beginning all the way to the end. What an awesome God. Glory. Hey, once again, brethren, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Everybody this morning, I love you guys in the name of Jesus, man. I thank you guys for your call. Thank you for your contributions. Remember, we don't take anything personal, and we should not take anything personal when it comes to the things of the Lord. Once we can validate the things in the Bible, let us come to a place where we can humble ourselves to acknowledge that God is speaking through his people. He's going to speak from every angle. That is the God we're talking about. This is what you call grace. This is what you call grace. Don't care how far you've gone, God will use anybody to come back and try to reach you back and say, look, I love you. I'm trying to send you a message. Just receive it. Receive it with meekness and humbleness. Receive it once the word of God can validate what we're talking about. Make sure you are humble to receive it for what it is. Glory to the name of Jesus, that in the last days, you are going to go on to glory. You're going to make it because you are able to submit yourself under the mighty hand of the word of God, which is the Bible. That, hallelujah, that's what it is. That's the victory is in Christ Jesus. We're not going to exalt ourselves like Satan and carry on like we are too big to come down. He said, come down, come down, receive me. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. All right, guys, good morning. Have a great day in the name of Jesus. Listen for Miss S later on. She have a special presentation in commemoration of this day.
He has to leave. Choice Radio. Life has always been about choices. Make the right choice today and choose Jesus.